CBS Evening News anchor claims his bosses were trying to, in his words, pacify the White House and used him as a scapegoat.
Democracy cannot survive, much less thrive, with the level of big corporate and big government interference and intimidation.
First Amendment dinner in Manchester, New Hampshire, a public cherishing of freedom of speech in the state with the two-fisted motto, live free or die. And the arsonist at the microphone, the former Speaker of the House, Newt Gingrich, was insisting that we must attach an on-off button to free speech. The colonial English defended their repression with words like those, and so did the slave states, and so did the policemen who shot strikers, and so did Lindbergh's America First crowd, and so did those who interned Japanese Americans, and so did those behind the Red Scare, and so did Nixon's plumbers. The genuine proportion of the threat is always irrelevant. The fear the threat is exploited to create becomes the only reality.
Were you a member of Skull and Bones in college and Bush? Were you in the same secret society?
That's right. Let me answer his question.
Excuse me, what are you asking for? Whoa. Is anybody watching me? I didn't do anything. Don't taste me, bro. Don't taste me. I can't do it.
The incident in Florida is the latest example of a nationwide trend toward censorship and control. Just a few nights ago, during the Fox Network broadcast of the Television Emmy Awards, Sally Field began to talk about the Iraq War, and Fox censored out this.
If the mothers ruled the world, there would be no wars in the first place.
The committee chairman, to discourage other protesters, began threatening arrests. This summer, Jeffrey and Nicole Rank told Hardball about how they got into a Bush event, refused to take off their anti-Bush t-shirts, and were arrested by security.
During a New Jersey appearance by First Lady Laura Bush, the mother of a son killed in Iraq disrupts the event and then is arrested by police outside the room. A solitary protester on an empty sidewalk, arrested.
How about you be placed under arrest?
Peaceful protesters herded far from the Democratic Convention in Boston and arrested by the hundreds and sent to a holding pen during the Republican Convention in New York, some held without arraignment for 3 days.
Here's the First Amendment I was reading. The right to free speech and free assembly. They arrested me for reading the Constitution.
Why is she being arrested?
Get my back.
Tell me what's going on, ma'am.
They just arrested me for peacefully talking.
Oh,